mamas and under your grandmas uptight, you hear? I fix up some chitlins and okra and black-eyed peas and some cornbread and pig's foot and northern beans and rice. And I'd like you to fall by a crib and whoop it on her. Crazy, said Red, so she started off through the woods. Little she know that the big bad wolf was making the local scene on a one night. And he fell out from behind the timber. He said, baby, give me some skin. Sorry, daddy-o, said Red, I gotta make it over my grandma's crib. Mama heard she was sick and thought she might like to pick up on some sticks. I'll dig you later, said the wolf. He made over grandma's house post-haste. Swallowed the old lady up, disguised himself in her night clothes, and stashed himself between the lily white. Red came upon the scene, which was a 21-story project made out of zigzag papers and scotch tape. And applying her hairy knuckles to the door, she laid down a crazy paradiddle and said, man, it's a raid. Fall in, said the wolf. What you got in the basket, sugar? Same old junk, said Red. Baby, don't put it down, said the wolf. I got it, said Red, it's getting heavy. Grandma, what great big eyes you have. That's a better to dig your tail feather with, my dear. And Grandma, your process is out of sight. I got myself straight on the south side. I don't want to sound square and ask for your draft card, but where's my grandma? Your grandma's gone, said the wolf. Don't hand me that jive, said Red, which infuriated the wolf so much that he leapt out of bed and began chasing Red around the room. Little did he know that the wolf season had opened that day and a nearby hunter was hit. He came on the scene and kicked down the door. Knocked out the window. Stepped on the grass.
Good grass or bad grass?
Oh, it was good grass.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he came in and saw a big bad wolf chasing Little Red Riding Hood around the bedroom, and he shot Little Red Riding Hood. Yeah, ran off and married the wolf.
Yeah.
You know why?
Why?
Because it was a fairy tale.